Greetings, ladies and gentlemen, it's me, Johnny, the Super Gamer Brothers, and this is my final thoughts on Sonic the Hedgehog's playthrough for Sonic 06. So, before we head into Silver's playthrough, let's begin on this, shall we? Now, over the course of the time I spent playing this game, Sonic has in no doubt become the character I've liked to play with the most. At first, that honor belongs to Blaze the Cat, who is not even a main character of the game. Because I've gotten so used to how Sonic handled in the Adventure series, I can never truly handle how ultra-precise Sonic's controls are in this game, especially when being sent skyrocketing with a dash pad. There are plenty of times where I find myself fidgeting left and right incredibly fast in an attempt to regain my composure and reset the camera to get a better view of my surroundings. I do like how the homing attack has been upgraded to home in on grind rails and such, and to be honest, I really don't mind it that I completely ignore gravity in this game when using it on an enemy or object that's above Sonic. For this game, I think that works just fine. Unfortunately, one of my biggest problems I have with Sonic's story is the process of killing Eggman's mechs over and over again. Yeah, there were enemies to kill in the Adventure series, but god damn it, they didn't throw nearly as many as this game does. Some of Sonic's upgrades can help ease the pain, but by the time you get most of them, you just want the game to end already. I wouldn't mind the sections where we switch to Tails or Knuckles if they played anything like they did in the Adventure games. Tails is almost painfully slow on the ground, and his dummy ring bombs are incredibly unreliable. Knuckles is just freaking useless. It takes forever to actually kill anything with him, and he's even slower than Tails. Did they honestly think this was a good idea? But without a doubt, one of my biggest complaints with Sonic has to be the overall structure of his story mode. We've all seen it. A lot of stages go absolutely nowhere in terms of progression. For a game called Sonic the Hedgehog, he sure does have the most pointless story. Nothing fucking happens in Sonic's story. Granted, I know they expect you to complete Silver and Shadow's playthrough to get the gist of things, but of all the three main heroes of the game, Sonic's story just feels like a waste of time. Hell, they even made us play one stage twice because they probably had no idea what to do with the blue bastard. In the end, we rescued the princess. Whoop-de-doo, we already did that like 5 fucking times within the same story, and the end result is just about as bare bones as you can get. I feel there's so many other things I can say, but there's plenty of time for that in the future. Now, I didn't bother showing the credits at the end of Sonic's playthrough, well, because I figured I could wait until we completely beat the game before doing so. But I do want to show off the two musical pieces that were played during Sonic's credits. The first song that plays is Sweet Dreams 2006 AKON Mix, which is a remix of the original Sweet Dreams song composed by Masato Nakamura and Miwa Yoshida of the band Dreams Come True, who composed the music for the first two Sonic the Hedgehog games. In fact, many of you might recognize this song as the theme that plays when Sonic is falling from the sky after destroying the Death Egg at the end of Sonic the Hedgehog 2. Yeah, it was originally a song created for a Dreams Come True album, and they reused it for Sonic 2. Personally, I like the Sonic 2 version more, but this song is a remix of the original version, so yes, there are lyrics, and honestly, I'm indifferent to it. Not a real big fan of AKON to begin with, but that's only because I'm completely unfamiliar with his works and I never had any interest to begin with. With that said, this is Sweet Dreams 2006 AKON Mix.
Just for you. I can see the moonlight
The next and final song that plays is His World, which is considered to be Sonic's theme for this game. Now, officially, there are three versions of this song. The one we're about to hear is the one played in-game, performed by Ali Tabata Bayi and Maddie Lewis of the band Zebrahead. There was also another version completely composed by the entire Zebrahead band, and finally a version produced by Crush 40. Personally, my favorite rendition is the one we're about to hear. I really do like this song, and it's definitely one of the few things I actually like about the game, but then again, I can probably say that for the entire soundtrack. Anyway, without further ado, this is His World. See you guys at the beginning of Silver's playthrough, which is coming real soon.
Pulling strings.